Nameless.
The protein of the future will likely be grown in a lab. And though it might sound kind of creepy at first, lab-grown meat won't require the slaughtering of animals and will involve a lot less water, agricultural resources, and ultimately pollution to produce. So here's a look at the process from petri dish to dinner plate. This is lab-grown meat, also known as cultured, clean, or test tube meat. It's grown from cell cultures in a laboratory. In 2013, Mark Post, a professor at Maastricht University in the Netherlands, was the first to showcase in vitro lab-grown meat. The production process for in vitro meats isn't as complicated as you might think. Growing cultured meat involves harvesting stem and muscle cells from a living cow and growing them together in the lab to create tissue. From that first tissue, scientists extract the muscle cells and place them in an artificial environment for the cells to grow into full muscle tissue. This muscle tissue is then collected to produce a meat patty, which is paler in color and slightly more neutral in taste than a regular burger. Today, a collection of over 15 independent enterprises and startups have begun working towards an affordable, tasty, lab-grown meat to be consumed by the masses. One startup, Memphis Meats, has found culinary success in growing meat in a lab. In 2016, the startup developed the first cultured beef meatballs. And then, in 2017, they showcased the first test tube poultry meats with chicken tenders and duck à l'orange. Once the production costs decrease, lab-grown meat has the power to replace global meat production, an industry with massively detrimental environmental effects. One study revealed that the livestock sector adds more to global greenhouse gas emissions than the entire transportation industry. Alternatively, similar studies reveal that lab-grown meat will produce 96% fewer greenhouse gas emissions than traditional beef. Lab-grown meat production also consumes 82 to 96% less water and virtually eliminates the land requirements needed to raise livestock. These new lab meats could have widespread health benefits too, since they can be grown with healthy omega-3 fatty acids and without saturated fat, thereby reducing the risk of heart disease and other chronic illnesses that traditional meats cause. Researchers also predict lab-grown meats will one day be a less expensive option and would make meat more accessible in developing countries. It could also alleviate some of the nutritional deficiencies in these populations and act as a sustainable protein source in communities where protein wasn't formerly available. So, what do you think? Would you eat a steak that was grown from a petri dish?
Nameless.